Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. It might be the greatest surprise for mainstream cosmologists since the dawn of the space age, the detection of powerful magnetic fields at all scales throughout the universe. In recent years, with the ever-finer detection of cosmic magnetism, astrophysicists have increasingly sought an answer to the problem, an answer which might somehow be compatible with acceptable Big Bang cosmology. It's important to note, as we've done in numerous past episodes, that mainstream cosmologists did not predict the so-called magnetic universe. In fact, a telling glimpse into the prevailing thoughts on cosmic magnetism could be found in the 1999 NASA piece entitled "Do Magnetic Fields Exist Throughout Space?" It states, "On the cosmological scale, there is no data to suggest that magnetic fields are present. They certainly are not important in the dynamics of the universe for any reasonable range of field strengths consistent with present observational constraints. However, today, not only do mainstream cosmologists view cosmic magnetism as important, some astrophysicists are counting on mysterious magnetism to resolve ad hoc some of the biggest evidentiary problems for the Big Bang hypothesis." In this episode, we've asked retired professor of electrical engineering, Dr. Donald Scott, to offer his thoughts on the real source of cosmic magnetism in our electric universe.
Another press release, "Uncovering the Hidden Magnetic Universe," is the title of this one. It should make astrophysicists even more embarrassed. In this release, the following words appear, and I quote directly from the press release. Quote, "Anytime astronomers figure out a new way of looking for magnetic fields in ever more remote regions of the cosmos, inexplicably, they find them." Now, here's another word that pops out, and I can't get by. The word "inexplicably" means that although they found the magnetic fields they were looking for, they have no idea why or how they got there. Otherwise, why else would they call them inexplicable? Anyway, continuing the quote, "These force fields," well, magnetic field isn't exactly a force field, but anyway, "these force fields, the same entities that emanate from fridge magnets, surround Earth, the Sun, and all galaxies. 20 years ago, astronomers started to detect magnetism permeating entire galaxy clusters, including the space between one galaxy and the next. Invisible field lines swoop through the intergalactic space like the grooves of a fingerprint. Although they admit to the existence of magnetic fields, they refuse to study or even consider the existence of the electric currents that cause those magnetic effects." That's how the magnetic fields get there, electric currents. How those magnetic fields got there is now one of their big, quote, "enigmatic, inexplicable puzzles." These connections between galaxies are not just magnetism, as the release says. They're plasma filaments. And there are no grooves in space. There are no grooves in the magnetism, because there's no such thing in our real three-dimensional world as a magnetic field line. They only exist on a blackboard when you're giving a lecture, or on paper when you're reading a book, or in our minds as a visualization tool to visualize what these fields actually look like, what shapes they take on. Anyway, there are a few important things, I think, that everybody must know about magnetic fields. And apparently, most astronomers do not have any idea that this is true. First one is that magnetic fields are smooth and continuous. They don't contain lumps or stringy things or stringy lines. As I've said many times, to quote myself, there are no pinstripes in magnetic fields. You can draw streamlines in a diagram of a flow of fluid to show where it goes and where it's strongest and how it's stronger in one area. Say the center of a river, you have more streamlines out there because there's more water moving more quickly than nearer the banks of the river. But after you've drawn these lines, you can't then claim that these really exist in three-dimensional space. Don't get in a rowboat and row out in the river with a fish hook and try to get a hold of any of those streamlines. They're not there. They're invisible, as the release points out, because they don't actually exist. They're abstractions, visualization techniques, and that's all they really are. Also, magnetic fields are created by electric currents or time-varying electric fields. Let me say that twice, because it's very important. Maxwell showed, and specifically one of his major equations, that electric currents or time-varying electric fields are the two possible causes of a magnetic field. That's the only way magnetic fields are created. Electric currents themselves are created, that is to say, induced, when a conductor, say a plasma cloud, cuts through a magnetic field. That's how the electric generator or the alternator in your car works. The conducting wires in the generator rotor cut through the magnetic field of the permanent magnet of the stator of the generator, and the current is induced. It's created to flow. Magnetic fields cause electric currents, and electric currents cause magnetic fields. You can't have one without the other. There are permanent magnets, I agree, made from magnetizable materials such as iron. And whenever I say anything like what I'm saying now, somebody will say, "Oh, well, what about bar magnets? What about those fridge magnets?" Well, they're like the ones in your car's alternator. Yes, they are there. They're in fridge magnets, but there are no iron bar magnets floating around out there in space. So that's not the cause of the magnetic fields in space. The permanent magnets are created by taking iron, which is magnetizable. That is to say, if you once wrap a coil of wire around a hunk of iron, you can pass current through the coil and create a magnetic field that even when you take the coil and the current away, the bar will remain magnetized. That's called remnant magnetism. But it requires a hunk of iron or something like iron, some ferromagnetic material. So it isn't that that's causing the magnetic fields that they see in space. Electric currents that create magnetic fields are, by definition, streams of moving electric charges. What caused them to move? Pseudo-skeptics often ask. Well, what causes anything to move out in the cosmos? Often we don't know. But everything in cosmic space is moving around. And every electric current will create a magnetic field. So magnetic field lines were invented by Michael Faraday as a technique for draftsmen to show their shapes. Artists and draftsmen use them all the time as artifices to help us visualize those shapes. And the artist who created with one of the figure that was included with this press release, obviously used an etching tool to show the grooves that we mentioned earlier that the releases talk about. Unfortunately, this person did not know that magnetic fields do not have beginnings and or ends. They're continuously closed loops. And the artist should have shown them all as closed loops. There's often a description of the magnetic field of the sun as leaving the sun from a footprint on the surface. And then these magnetic fields, these astronomers say, go out into space and go to infinity. Well, there's no beginning, there's no footprints for magnetic fields, and they don't go to infinity. All magnetic fields are closed loops, and the word that's used in electrical science is solenoidal. Magnetic fields are solenoidal. They're closed loops. They must be closed loops with no beginning or end. They're usually drawn with directional arrows. I agree with that. These arrows only show the direction of the field vectors at every point along such a line. They do not imply motion. We should be very careful not to infer motion from an arrow on a magnetic field line. Nothing moves along any of Faraday's field lines. The arrows only indicate the direction of the vector field at each point along those lines. Charges actually do move along lines of electric current, however. That's very different. These are very different lines. When you draw a line of current density, charges are real particles that really do exist in 3D space, and they really do move. But there's no such thing as a magnetic particle. Somebody once talked about a magneton. They tried to discover a magneton, but they failed again. They don't exist. It's an abstraction. So how do astrophysicists explain where magnetic fields come from? How do they actually explain it? They don't. That's the answer. Because we always must remember that astronomers had to be dragged, kicking and screaming, into acknowledging the presence of magnetic fields in space. This second press release says that happened about 20 or so years ago. I think that's right. Now, radio telescopes demonstrate that they're there quite clearly. But astronomers, helioastronomers and astrophysicists, even now, refuse to go the rest of the way and accept the fact that the presence of those magnetic fields, which indeed are there, that presence requires electric currents to be present also. That's how those magnetic fields are created, by electric currents. One of the most compelling pieces of evidence for the existence of supersized Birkeland currents came from the discovery of faint superscale radio emission that connects the Coma cluster of galaxies and the Abel 1367 cluster. We're talking about two clusters of galaxies. Now, a galaxy by itself is unimaginably large, but now you're talking about clusters of galaxies, and you have two different clusters of galaxies widely separated by distances that are unimaginable, and there's a tremendous current between those two galaxy clusters. And the radiation's properties indicate that magnetic field strengths correspond to a classic galactic Birkeland current of nearly, would you believe, 10 to the 19th amperes. That's one followed by 19 zeros. That's a lot of current. So anyway, the second press release goes on to ask, quote, where do these enormous magnetic fields come from? That's a good question. Where did they come from? The quote says, it clearly cannot be related to the activity of a single galaxy or single explosions or winds from supernovae, said one astrophysicist at the University of Bologna who makes state-of-the-art computer simulations of cosmic magnetic fields. Now, this fellow who said that makes state-of-the-art computer simulations of cosmic magnetic fields. Just hold on a second. How can anyone make a computer simulation if they don't have the vaguest idea of what causes what they're trying to simulate? Computers have to be programmed with mathematical expressions that describe the interactions of the basic physical entities that give rise to the phenomenon you're trying to simulate. How are you going to simulate something when you don't know what has to be present to simulate it, to create it? The press release continues, quote, one possibility is that cosmic magnetism is primordial, tracing all the way back to the birth of the universe. Okay, in other words, it's always been there. The Big Bang must have put it there. And continuing the quote, in that case, weak magnetism should exist everywhere, even in the voids of the cosmic web, the very darkest, emptiest regions of the universe. The omnipresent magnetism would have seeded the stronger fields that blossomed in galaxies and clusters, end quote. Now, wait a minute. First of all, there are no true voids in space. Every single time, a deep image is made or has been made of where astronomers have previously thought they saw a void in the cosmos, more distant faint galaxies come up on the result. So no matter where they look, there are galaxies. There's no such thing as a void. But magnetic fields do not just give birth to, they use the word seed, other magnetic fields. But to put it, I think, appropriately, magnetic fields do not get pregnant. So now their explanation seems to be that any newly discovered magnetic field was born once upon a time from or seeded by some other magnetic field. Why? How? Maxwell never heard about this. He never heard about a seeding process that creates magnetic fields. Neither did Faraday or anyone else. It's another mythical fiction. As a favorite comedian of mine, Anna Russell, I don't know how many people remember her, but she was a British lady, very, very clever and very funny, I thought. She used to narrate the wildly fantastic mythical stories told in Richard Wagner's Ring Cycle operas about, you know, people walking over rainbows and things like that. And she used to say in her high voice with a British accent, I don't know if I can do it, I'm not making this up, you know. This is the story being told, she said. Don't blame it on me. Well, this is the state of modern day astrophysicists. We're being exposed to a mythical tale told round a campfire.